After I'd been here a while, and after I'd come to realise how much success meant to this football club, it became fairly apparent to me that one of the things that the players were going to have to deal with this season, bearing in mind the money we were going to spend and how it was going to be talked about, players were going to have personality. They were going to have a football personality. They were going to have to be able to deal with not only the football, and if possible, even better than that, they're going to have to be bigger than the football. Vinny, as we all know, has this larger-than-life personality, and I thought that would be an asset to this football club. In the situations we're going to encounter in the second division, in addition to his footballing ability. And I think he's done that. We're still hearing about the hard man Vinnie Jones. Well, to be fair, he's been slightly disappointing in that respect. I don't think he has been the hard man Vinnie Jones. And I don't mean that in any sense of going out and performing outside the laws of the game. He's only been booked twice, and his contribution has been probably a contribution that no one suspected when I signed him. And I knew that the eyebrows would be raised, and I knew that people would start to make allusions and references to the so-called Leeds of old. But in my mind, I knew what I wanted, and I knew he was capable of doing it. I saw different things in Jones to the things people felt weren't there. After all, you know, he had played in a Wimbledon team that had finished fifth in the first division, that had won a cup final against Liverpool, and during the course of that, you know, managed to shove most of the others off the front or back page of the newspaper for one reason or another. He has a personality. He's prepared to stand up for himself, and he's prepared to say what he thinks. But then there's nothing wrong with that.